last week I came across such a hilarious tweet. I think it was either last week or 2 weeks ago, and I remember I shared it with some of my friends. The tweet is in a bit of Zulu and English, so please forgive me. My Zulu is very bad, like hectic. The tweet said, "They dump you because abasakufuni. God is not preparing you for anything better. Abasakufuni. Let me repeat that. What did I just say? And I agree with the tweet to some degree. And what I mean is, if you're a person who does not value what they go through and who does not understand the importance of experience, then God is not preparing you for anything better. And what I mean by that is always playing the victim. Blaming the universe, blaming others, blaming that person who dumped you, thinking that they owe you, feeling sorry for yourself all the damn time, then God is surely not preparing you for anything better. This is where I agree with the tweet. It's solely dependent on you. If you're going to, you need to allow the universe and you need to allow God to prepare you for things in the future, for better things in the future, but that is all dependent on you. This say God is preparing you for something better is solely dependent on you. So basically, you're on your own. Some things that happen to you is just you and that thing, and it'll depend on you whether you're going to learn from that thing, grow from that thing, and move. Find a corner somewhere and cry for years and waste your life while other people are living their best lives. So everything that's happening to you right now in life, or everything that happened to you, is your responsibility to come out of it. Doesn't matter whether someone hurt you, doesn't matter whether someone broke your heart, doesn't matter whatever happens to you, doesn't matter whether someone dies. How you feel is your responsibility, unfortunately, at the end of the day. You have to make plans on how you're going to move on from that. But just remember that you have to move on from that. Allow yourself to go through all the emotions and also allow yourself to grow through things. You need to allow yourself to grow through things so that you can be a better person, so that you can create your own fate, so that you can just allow great things to happen to you. Abasakufuni, they don't want you no more, so move along. And of course, this is not only to be applied on one thing. You apply this mindset, a growth mindset, to your everyday life, your everyday experiences, maybe at work, romantic relationship. What else is there? Allow things to happen to you. Allow God to prepare you for something better. Allow the universe to prepare you for something better. Give yourself the opportunity to learn and to grow at all times. Just do that. To recap and to wrap this up, I don't want my videos to be long anymore. I don't like lengthy videos, actually. But if you've watched until now, thank you so much for watching. And yes, this book is great. Please get it if you can. It'll change your life. It's readable. One of the best books I've read. So I would like to leave you with this. This is basically my message, what I was talking about and what the tweet reminded me of. There was a saying in the 1960s that went, "Becoming is better than being." The fixed mindset does not allow people the luxury of becoming. They have to already be. Can I read that again? Becoming is better than being. The fixed mindset does not allow people the luxury of becoming. They have to already be. Hence, I was stressing so much about growth and learning. But if you have a fixed mindset, you are not becoming. You are already, whatever that you fixed your mind to believe that you are. So, yeah, get this book, guys. It's pretty good. I love it so much. Please subscribe, please like, please comment. Please, guys, I'll see you next time. I'm outie! Give me your chance, better make it better.